Good evening, everyone. I'm Frank Novak, and welcome to this Senate candidate edition of Point of Reference. Tonight, a brief glimpse of the seven candidates running for office, Republicans, Democrats, and Independents. We're talking with Attorney Paul Magliocchetti, who is also the Haverhill School Committee Vice President. Welcome to the program, Paul.
Thank you very much, Mr. Novak.
Okay, let's see if we can get to some questions right off the bat. Companies look for a skilled, educated workforce, you've said. And as a school committeeman, what can you tell us that you've done to move that issue forward as an example of what you can bring to the Senate for a statewide benefit?
Absolutely. I appreciate the question. I think that's real important because the economy is on everyone's mind in this election. From when I first got on the school committee, I have been engaging the Whittier Vocational Technical School in our dialogues. I've called them before the school committee several times. We've had a dialogue. We now have, because of actions that I've taken, we have a school committee member that is also on the Whittier Tech School Committee. So we have a good line of communication. It is very important that we have cooperation among the high school, the Whittier Vocational Technical School, Northern Essex Community College, and UMass Lowell. We are working very hard towards that. People at Haverhill High School have the opportunity to take courses not only at the vocational school, but they can take college-level courses at both NECO and UMass Lowell. What this does is that helps us achieve the goal of having students upon graduation be ready for either further college, further educational study, or to enter the workforce with some real-world skills. That's really what we need to do. You know, we have these students graduating from high school that really have no direction. They don't have any real-world skills. They're not going on to college. We send them out there with this diploma, but they don't know how to apply anything. I think one of the most important things that we can do as a society is to make sure that all of our high school graduates are qualified for either college or for the workforce. And I think we've done a lot of that since I've been on the school committee, and I'm going to continue putting those issues on the agenda to move that forward.
Okay. To create jobs and economic development, you'd minimize regulations, such as?
Absolutely. I think that we need to look at all the regulations involved with starting up a company in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. As an example, there are zoning regulations that apply even in our industrial parks that regulate the kinds of businesses that can go in there. The communities do work together with businesses to get them through, but it takes time. There's a whole process involved. I do a lot of zoning work in my practice. I represent businesses, and they're always trying to put a certain type of business in a location. And 9 times out of 10, you do get the local approvals, but it usually takes 3, 4, 5 months before you go through the whole process. And there's also a huge cost involved with that, with getting engineers involved, getting attorneys involved, getting the boards involved, the fees you pay the municipalities. I think something needs to be done to have more of a cooperative effort and a streamlined approach so that when businesses want to expand or want to come into a community, they get assistance from both the state and the city level so that they don't have to wait 5 or 6 months to get the ball rolling. They can get going quicker, and I think those are the kinds of things we need to look at.
You want new legislation to bring back manufacturing. What would your proposed law look like?
The first thing I would do is implement what I've found to be called economic gardening. I've done a lot of research at other states. I've looked at studies that have been done on states that have been able, even in this down economy, to attract new business, especially manufacturing business. And a common theme that I found in many of them, Texas, for example, is that they have this streamlined approach, again, where they have one grant funding agency, where if you want to start up a business in the state and you show a business plan that can establish over a 5-year period that you're going to have steady growth, that you're going to have steady income growth, and you're going to have the cash flow to manage it, then if you need some kind of assistance, some kind of whether it be the state co-signing on a loan, much like the SBA, the federal government does in the SBA process, this one government agency will cooperate with you and help you get not only any grants that might be available, will help you get loans through private banks, Right now, the problem we have in the Commonwealth is we have too many agencies and people get confused. They don't know where to go. So I think we need a streamlined approach, and through economic gardening, we would have one government entity or office that manages all types of businesses so that you don't ask these questions. You know where to go. They will have the answers for you. It's all a matter of having a business plan that you can convince people works, and then the state puts you in connection with the banks, private banks, that can ultimately help you get things going. Because we have to get the government out of business, put it in the private sector where it belongs. We just need the government to help facilitate that.
Okay. I'm going to ask you this question in the same way that I've asked one of the other candidates the same question. There are three attorneys running for this particular spot, and you are one of them. And under our health care system, statistically, one in four tests that doctors order, they say are not necessary because that drives the cost of health care up. But they do it because of a defensive mechanism so as not to be sued. You're an attorney. Would you push for tort reform? And if so, how would you do it in a legislature dominated by attorneys?
I absolutely believe in tort reform. First of all, that's not my area of specialty. I do handle some personal injury cases. I usually refer those matters out. But I do believe in tort reform. Back when I was in law school, I actually had a professor, my tort professor, and he and I used to have conversations outside of the classroom. And even he believed that we need some kind of tort reform. You can't have doctors working under the stress that they work worry about getting sued all the time. Doctors do need to be held to a very high standard. I mean, I don't know of any profession that so much is at stake. It's human lives. You can't put a value on a human life. So do we want to keep them from making mistakes? Absolutely. Do we want to hold them accountable when they're grossly negligent? Absolutely. But there's a better way to do it, and I do think that there has to be tort reform. There has to be a serious dialogue with it. We have to get the lobbyists out of the picture. It's not so much the fact that we have these attorneys in the legislature, but we have the legal lobbies working with the legislators. And one of the reasons I'm running as an independent is I don't want any connections to any lobbyists or any of that baggage that entails. So I think that I can do the right thing because it's the right thing to do, and I can be a strong advocate as an attorney and as an independent. I can go in there and actually facilitate the kind of reforms that we need, unlike any other person in this race. I'm probably the only candidate that can do that effectively.
Thanks very much. Attorney Paul Magliocchetti, Haverhill School Committee Men, and running for the first Essex Senate seat. Thanks very much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
I hope that you've listened and learned in an effort to help you decide which candidate to support in the upcoming election. And on Election Day, remember to vote, because if you don't vote, you don't count, and everyone should count. And as always, we hope that this program has been a point of reference for you. And until next time, my name is Frank Novak, and thanks very much for watching.